It's easier to see the dugging in the vein. Cause every word I sketch on the paper, you feel the pain. It's easy, it's probably hard to tell niggas like me. Cause you've been bitch all your life and you ain't moving like me. Son, I'm a diamond in the dirt, rocks ain't gotta get searched. I've been calling God for bars, also part of my curse. And it's real, it's easier to see the thugging in the vein. Cause every word I sketch on the paper, you feel the pain.
Hit me if you're interested in any other advertisements that we be doing that y'all be seeing all across all platforms, social media and all that. Say, yo, I like that, or I like this, or I like that. Hit me and we can do it. We can make it work. Alright? Now, I want to get into something very important to me, sensitive to me, and I'm vulnerable with this because I don't like to disclose any of my personal fears, but we living in a time where it's necessary, you know. Personally, I have to pray all throughout the day. That's what we're talking about today. Prayer and work, you know what I'm saying? So, little man, he gonna rock with me, all right, for this podcast.
Break out the champagne.
One ice cube. Chardonnay, one ice cube.
Thank you. Started off sexy, what he said.
Watch the shoes, man.
Why can't we have fun too?
Well, they all screaming for more. Ushers walk me to the door as soon as I step in, all off-white velours. Handsome dog, you suppose until I talk, try place me. You pose until I walk, nice linen. Roll up the sleeves, ice glisten. Everybody watch it, observe the words of my sentence. The charm as you light up, it's like you really repentant. The car self-startup, it's like you're still in the spirit as you finish.
We're going to be talking about various topics each and every Sunday night at 10 p.m. Liquor, Puppies, and Weed is going strong. That's on all platforms. Go and support that thing. Tonight we have some announcements that we want to make. Aside from the mixtape, y'all already know what it is. We have a lot of online offers, okay? Not just pertaining to what I'm doing and Cakewalk and at Cakewalk, but also what you're doing. We're interested in what you want to do. So we build online stores. You know what I'm saying? Call my number, hit me 347-995-6755 and speak to me directly. You know what I'm saying? And we can make an online profitable business for you. We could LLC it for you. We could trademark it, register it. So, you know, you get to income taxes, which is coming up. May not be able to do it that quick, but you never know. Call me, contact me. And if you got your business together, you got your paperwork right, you know what I'm saying? Cost your investment, we can make it happen. All right, tonight now. Oh, we also, you know, do press releases. If you need press release and promo runs and stuff like that. You see what we're doing, it's kind of crazy. Hit me if you're interested in any other advertisements that we be doing that y'all be seeing all across all platforms, social media and all that. Say, yo, I like that, or I like this, or I like that. Hit me and we can do it. We can make it work. Alright? Now, I want to get into something very important to me, sensitive to me, and I'm vulnerable with this because I don't like to disclose any of my personal fears, but we living in a time where it's necessary, you know. Personally, I have to pray all throughout the day. That's what we will talk about today. Prayer and work. You know what I'm saying? So, little man, he gonna rock with me, alright, for this podcast. Prayer and work. It's a simultaneous thing. Simultaneous thing. It goes hand in hand. So, but at the same time, you never want to do one and then be worrying about doing the other one. Prayer deserves its personal time without thinking about working. You know what I'm saying? And then when you're working, you already in a perpetual state of prayer anyway. You know, so we don't ever want to knock prayer, but when you work and get it done, you know what I mean? You go to people's house, for example, somebody say, bless the food. Bless the food. Don't go into a whole sermon and all of that. And the Lord told me, and he told me this, man, Lord, thank you for this food. In Jesus' name, bless it. Let it nourish us. And amen. You know what I'm saying? You ain't got to go. I saw Moses on the mountain, and he saw me descending from Mount Zion. And we ain't actually there. It's actually bless the food.
Back in the loom pack, making tunes back like a pack epidemic, hitting game, boom, word up. Regardless of home back, I'm well grown. I'm looking like I came back strapped. Y'all have a whole connection, all that was good. I spit flu and Christ and flow, it's nice to do it. The LS in the smack when I shoot it because I'm probably. Listen to me. Back in the loom pack, making tunes back like a pack epidemic, hitting game, boom, word up. Regardless of home back, I'm well grown. I'm looking like I came back strapped. Y'all had a hoop, nigga, all hell do. I spit fluent, Christ influence, nice to do it. The illest in the slight when I shoot it, because I hardly ever aim at you losers. I'm feeling like my face is in the light, like the Judas. The critics say I got issues, but I'm far from the Judas. Man, this is live. I kick an A line of my music, I'm coming live. Some people say the church is polluted, I spit it hard. Sometimes I might domestic abuse it. Sunshine still delivered, because I spit it the truest. It's how I do it, nigga, stupid.
Then that time I went and said goodbye.
So that's the same thing with praying and working. When you're praying, bro, sis, give it everything you've got, man. Preferably in like a closet or in at the crib where there's nobody around early in the morning, 2, 3, 4 in the morning. You know what I'm saying? And give it everything, man. If you gotta cry, cry. If you gotta weep, weep. If you gotta whatever, you know what I'm saying? Give it your all when it comes to praying. When it comes to going out to work, same thing, give it your all. In other words, pray as if everything depended on God. And work as if everything depended on you. That's how I approach it, you know what I'm saying? When I go into a prayer module, which is all throughout the day, it is fervent prayer. It is a deep thing. It's not just a gimme list and looking at God like he's Santa Claus. Nah. But a deep prayer is deeper than just requesting a list of asking for something. See, when I go into my closet of prayer, man, I'm praying with a burning desire because I desire to see something manifest that may not be in the physical at the moment, but I see it so profoundly that in my mind, it's already materialized. I could smell it, I could taste it, I could touch it. So when I'm praying, it's already in full vision. So then when I'm done with that, I leave that in God's hands. That's it, that's him. You know, now it's time to get up after all of that praying and stuff like that and go execute. See, because when you transition into the work aspect and you're done with the prayer, when you are in the work mode, you're still really in prayer mode, but it's now the manifestation of seeing your prayer come to pass. It is a continual prayer. The work isn't prayer. You understand what I'm saying? When you're praying, you are praying for the desired result to transition, I mean, to take place, to transition and come into fruition. The work is the actual seeing of it. You putting in the diligence. You know what I'm saying? Last episode we talked about being something. You know, wanting to do something or wanting to be somebody. And then as an adult, you start doing waste management or something. The prayer is the burning desire. When you go into the courts and his gates, you come in with thanksgiving and you come in with praise. celebrating that the prayer is already granted, that you have full access to what you have asked for. And not just the asking of it, but the actual now being in the will of it, knowing that the petition was heard and now it's time for the execution of that thing. So that prayer is sent up and left in God's hands. Pray like everything depends on God. Then put that work in like it depended on you. See, not to get too out of topic, but the spirit needs a body to make them things happen. And we need the spirit to take care of the supernatural parts that we can't do. But in the physical realm, the spirit needs you to work, to work, to work. The praying, that's all he knocked out. The praying is all on God's hands. But the execution of the thing is on your hands, B. You got to get up and make what you see in your mind come into reality. And with that being said,
I'm back and not ashamed to cry. Ooh, baby.
Simultaneous, I'm back spitting niggas through instances. Looking down from Phoenix to Hades. I'm hitting niggas cranium, spitting amazingness. Changing up the game, plus I kick the pages. Four finger ringing it, daddy king 24 carat gold chain hanging it. Looking like me, jeans sagging on the slight. The way I got you looking at my wrist, just assume that my pocket's right. Half past flash recording, I ain't got a flash to Yankee. Fitted hat, leather cap, flash form. I'm fast forward from the project steps, but at the same time, rewind to my project set. I recline in it. Cause I'm project bread, my origin comes from Bushwick, I'm a project head. That's the time I'm rolling, I'm representing Brooklyn, I show it. Yeah, I love the Lord too, but I'm hood, you know, kick, kick.
And that time I went and said,